First of all, I started to dance professionally when I was 18. I joined the Ram Gopal group in London. I was 18 then. And so it's now more than 70 years that I have been in the profession of dance. During which time, earlier, when I was with Ram, I used to do Bharatanatyam. You must have seen some photographs. And I enjoyed that. But when it came to Abhinaya and the songs and the language, I was not very comfortable with that. Being a North Indian, you know, I was not so comfortable with the South Indian languages or even the South Indian culture, you know. So then I stuck to Kathak. And I took a government scholarship to learn with Shambhu Maharaj, to learn with Sundar Prasad, and then work with Birju Maharaj. And that is how I came into Kathak very seriously. But training in Kathak, one learns the format, one learns the technique, one learns how to recite your tukras, one learns the bowl patterns, everything. But after that, what? I thought, when am I going to dance? Is what I thought. Like, you know, when you learn a language, you learn the grammar, you learn the, you know, everything about the, but then you don't write grammar books. You have to go beyond that. So that is what I thought. I'm only repeating what my gurus are telling me to do. I am not dancing. My gurus are dancing through my body. You know, am I for Kathak or is Kathak for me? You see, that was the question in my mind. When you say Kathak, what do you mean? You mean just the format or the technique or the grammar? It has to go beyond, right? Must go beyond that. So I started looking beyond. And how does one do that? What is known as choreography? What is choreography? Like a painter has a canvas and he paints on that. What does he paint? His own ideas. His own ideas, right? So the dancer has the space. So dancer must put his own ideas. With the technique that you have, you use the technique, but the ideas and the mind and the soul and everything which comes and everything that you want to say, you should have to say something, no? Your life is not just beyond getting up every morning, going to bed every morning and then it's another day. You have to actually be wanting to leave something here.
So about what you want to say, can you tell me what sort of themes or what sort of, what did you put in your choreographies once you started doing your own work?
See, when we were training, the Abhinaya and whatever the choreography was from the older generation dance was always about mythology. It was always about gods. You know, we were always in the heavens, like Radha Krishna, Shiva Parvati, always about mythology. So I wanted to come down on earth, you know, and be with human beings, not always with gods, you see. So I thought, I didn't know what themes I would choose. I did not know. I was not sure. So I said, Kathak has got so much of the percussion, you know, that I thought, let me do some abstract work. No story. Does one have to have a story? Does dance always have to rely on a story? Can it not? It's not an art which can stand on its own. So I started doing abstract work. The first thing I ever did was called Dhapkar. Dhapkar means the pulse. See, it's something we don't think about all. We never think about in the body. You see, we think about our face, we think about our arms, we never think about our pulse. But that's the most important thing. So I said, I want to find out where is the pulse of Kathak. Where is it? Is it in the todas tukras, in the rhythms, in the abhinaya of the mythology? So I started using the movements from Kathak, the movements. It was all Kathak. I didn't know any other movements except for some of the Bharatanatyam. And I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to mix the two. Didn't want to borrow from any other. Wanted to be pure Kathak in its look. But I wanted to be without story.
Were you the first one also to go to compose for groups? Because if I remember well, Kathak is a solo.
It is a solo dance.
So one of your big innovations also was to compose for more dancers together.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes. Because the architects were building big stages. You see, so one little solo dancer, and then the light person had to, you know, make the other areas dark so that the dancer doesn't look lost on this huge stage. Anyway, that's a funny reason for that. But anyway, I wanted more and more people to dance together. I like this feeling of togetherness, you know, rather than this solo thing. I want people to dance together. Because I've seen so many folk dancers outside India and in India. And that kind of relationship they have with each other, you know, that camaraderie, it is so very vibrant and so very soul-touching that I thought, why can't we bring that in our classical dances also? Why not? Why not two people dance together? Why not six people dance together? And yet, not six solos, together. Because sometimes I've seen a group dance, you know, where six people do exactly the same thing. But that's not a group. That's six people doing six solos on the same stage. No. So I wanted to bring that feeling of togetherness.
From your experience, I understand that you have inspired a number of dancers and choreographers who are sort of continuing the work, maybe not your work, but who have been so inspired by you that they also are creating their own work.
Yes, yes. Like many of my own students, like Aditi Mangal Das, Daksha Sheth, Maulik Shah, they are doing their own now.
Yes.
And I'm happy to say they're not doing what I was doing. They're doing their own.
Right.
So that is saying something about my training in Kadam, that I did not create clones. You see, each individual was treated differently. Because everyone came with their own energy, with their own imagination, with their own mind. And that mind should never be subdued, which was happening in our classes. Don't think, just dance, do rehearse. And that is something which I wanted not to do in my class. I wanted each individual to grow individually. So today, if you find many of my students doing choreography, all of them are completely different, like Parul Shah in New York, Aditi Mangal Das, Daksha Sheth, they're all different. Because they're bringing their own imagination, their own, what they want to say in dance. They have understood what dance is, because they have understood that dance is meant for them. They are not meant for the dance. Dance is meant for them.
And talking about them, we are here in your institution where you have created generations of dancers. And so how does it work? Is it how, for example, when a student comes here, he will come for a certain number of years? How does it work?
No, it's see, we have a school, right?
Yeah.
Many students now want to come and dance here. At the time of when we take new students, there is a little queue here wanting to. When I first started, I had only 3 students. But it's become quite popular in the sense that everybody wants to learn dance. They don't all become dancers. Some people come because they just want to pass time. Or some come because the mother wants that one free hour where she can leave the child here and go and do her shopping, you know. And there are many reasons why people come, you know. Some people come because the neighbor's child is going, you know. There's lots of reasons why. So we take everybody. Everyone wants to come. But there are some who take it seriously.
Okay. And is it you have a company?
Now I have.
You have a company?
Yeah.
So the company is composed of some of those students?
Yeah, or they're all my students.
Sure.
They're all my old students.
Okay, you don't select dancers from other parts or from
companies? I would like to.
You would like to.
I would like to. But you know how it is? We're still not very open about this. We're still talking about this gharana and Jaipur gharana and Lucknow gharana. We're still a little reserved about the guru's training, and my guru may not like me joining you, and that kind of feeling is still there, unfortunately.
You mean that in the classical world of Kathak, there is still resistance about what you do?
Oh, lots of resistance. I will tell you, remember the year, in 1 year, I started those, we have these turns, pirouettes in Kathak. They were always done in one place. I started doing them around the stage, My guru said, this is ballet, this is not Kathak. Today, his own students are doing that. It's become Kathak vocabulary now. So there was resistance. Then once I did the Tihai, I broke the Tihai.
What is the Tihai?
Tihai is when you do one piece three times. A given segment done 3 times of bowls. Hmm? 3 times. So I divided it in 6 people like that. And they said, no, this is not classical. This is not traditional. You can't break it like that. So it's not a glass piece that you can't break, you know. Anyway, now everyone is doing that. It's become a Kathak vocabulary, okay? Some time back, I did one choreography, solo choreography for myself. It was called Duvidha, means conflict. Middle-aged woman, middle-class woman, Indian woman, stuck in the course of her home. You know, she gets up in the morning, cooks for the children, sends the children to school. Her husband's this thing, washes the clothes. Then what does she do? She's chained to that household work. And then she reads some newspapers and all, and she reads some magazines where she sees a woman you know, with fancy hairdos and sleeveless blouses and makeup and all that. She says, can I ever be like that? Why can't I be like that? That was the story, theme. So she has a frame of mind in which she thinks that. So on the stage, I put a frame. It, for the woman at home, I used sarod music, no tala, it's just alap. And then suddenly she goes into this frame, and I used electronic music. Electronic music. And movements around this frame and with the frame and all that. And today, of course, it's been considered a masterpiece today. But when I did it, one of the critics in Delhi, Hindustan Times, Subbadu his name was, he said, Indian dance from sublime to ridiculous. You see, that sublime was gone. What he meant by sublime, I don't know. And if it is ridiculous to be a housewife, I don't know what his wife was doing at that time. You know? Anyway.
Yeah, well.
So, but let me tell you, yeah. After 20 years, I met that same critic in Delhi, in the same theater, when I put up another work. And what did he say about me? Kumudini is the savior of the Kathak dance. I went to him, I said, Subbadu, I think I was 20 years ahead of you. He said, yes, yes, you were. So that, you know, I've had to struggle through all this. But luckily, I never took it to heart. Criticism never bothered me. I thought that is one step further. It never bothered me. I never became unhappy. Oh, why, now I stop doing this. And not at all. I said, now I must do more of it.
Where do you perform? You perform in India. You were mentioning you are having a tour.
Yeah.
And you go abroad also.
Yeah.
Where to? Which are the most welcoming places in the world for your work?
I think Europe is very welcoming. Italy, Germany.
France.
I haven't been to France recently. I haven't been to France. I don't know why, but we recently went to Italy and to Spain. And they're very welcoming. And oh, they said, why is it only one show? Please do more shows, do more shows. Germany also. Now, actually, I went with Ram Gopal to Germany just after the war, when all the buildings were like this, supported in Berlin, you know, except for the cathedral. The cathedral was standing straight, and all the buildings were like this. And we went to Germany just after the war. And the people would go mad. Even after the curtain came down, they would clap, 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 stand in queues at the... So I thought, what is this? Their eyes were so full of the colors of war. All the smoke and the grays and the, you know, that they were so happy to see all these beautiful colors. And it meant something to them, even if they don't understand the dance. All those colors. And they wanted more and more of that. It was just after the war. It was really, yeah, very touching, very touching. Today, Germany is different. Today is different. Today, they appreciate what you're doing. The critics, they read about Indian dance and come to watch. England used to be like that before. London used to be like that before. London was very, very good before. But today there are too many Indians in London. Indians who are non-dancers who are dancing, running dance schools, you know, and hundreds of students learning dance, Indians, all Indian students coming from Leicester and all these little places, you know. I mean, it's become a kind of a, Dance has become a commodity now in England, unfortunately. London used to be beautiful at that time. When I toured in London with Ram Gopal, you know, we used to go and see Covent Garden. I saw Ulanova in Covent Garden. Galina Ulanova I saw in Covent Garden. It was at that time.
That memories.
Yeah, that memory is there when we used to dance in the West End, Prince's Theatre and Wimbledon Theatre, and those memories are beautiful. But dance is something different today. It's very easily available. On the other hand, I'm very happy that so many people are learning the dance. I'm happy about that, you know. But now, you know, there are lots of girls in America who are learning dance. They're learning Bollywood dance also. There are lots of schools for Bollywood. And those who are learning Kathak, in their holidays, they come here to India, to their grandmother or to, you know. They come to my school and they said, hey, will you teach me? I said, yeah, sure. But how long are you here? I'm here for 2 months. I said, no, this is not shop. They come shopping. Along with the clothes, they come shopping for dance. I don't encourage that at all. Yeah. I'm serious about dance. I've spent so much, my whole life I've spent after dance, you know. Even though dance happened to me as not destined, but it just happened, you know. So, and then I took it seriously.
Do you see the very new generation who do contemporary in a more radical way, like in Delhi or also Chennai, or these choreographers who do things in a more radical way and more contemporary, whatever that means?
Yeah.
Whatever that means. But do you see them? Are you interested?
Yes, I did see them. In fact, my group did one contemporary group. Just, I wanted them to experience.
So
there is Santosh Nair in Delhi. Santosh. Yes. He's supposed to be very good. I invited him for a workshop. And my students, they learned. And he composed a bit. And they do it now on the stage. It's appreciated. Now we're not doing anymore. This was one experience. I wanted them to know what contemporary dance is, you know, and how they feel, how their bodies could take it. And it's funny, he said, your girls can do contemporary dance, it's fantastic, because they also do kalari. They do kalari, so their bodies are quite strong. It's very important. Kathak alone will not build up your body. It won't. So we do kalari, we do contemporary, we do.
Do you want to add anything? Or I have finished my questions.
Yes.
Is there anything you would like to add?
It's, even though it has been difficult, my life in dance, I've enjoyed every moment of it. And if I was to be reborn, I would like to be reborn again as a dancer.
Great. Thank you very much.
No,
thank you very
it was pleasant talking to you. starts with these two people sitting on a bench in a garden, in a park. They don't know each other. It's how it starts. They don't know each other. She's folding her clothes and busy doing something. He realizes there's a girl there. So he looks, you know, and then looks a little more. And a little more. Then he gets up and does a little dance. You know, that first image, I had seen Peena Bausch many years ago. And it was, I had this image in my mind from her, one of her pieces, which I've tried to repeat here. So when you said that, where do I get my, I look at everything, you know. I look at all dance. And those, some of those images remain in my, and I try to bring them into Kathak. So this was from Peena Bausch. Many, many, many years ago, I had seen her in Germany. In fact, I went to a place in Wuppertal. And then one of my most favorite was Kurt Hughes, The Green Table. You remember that? He made it just after the war, The Green Table. It's a very famous piece by Kurt Hughes, the famous German composer. You know? And these are people who are deciding about the war. It's called The Green Table. It's a beautiful piece. That memory lingers in my mind. Things like that. Like if I have seen the Russian ballet, Baryshnikov, something like that, you know, and try to make her do it. You see, all this,
I inspires
try to bring,
you.
Inspires me, I try to bring it into Kathak.
Yes.
Because Kathak is a dance language. It's not restricted to one family or one address of Jaipur or one address in Lucknow, you see. It doesn't have a postal address, you know. So I had. And you saw all these girls, how they were happy dancing together. That's
what you were saying.
That's
before.
What I was saying.
Yeah.
After all, dance must bring happiness. And if it comes like this, nothing better.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody.
Annette.
And all the best to you all.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah.
Keep dancing.
Keep dancing, yeah.